friends, so we are going to do a class today for inversions, specifically plough pose or halasana as it's known in Sanskrit. We'll do some shoulder stands and variations of shoulder stands. So if you can't quite get to a shoulder stand, we'll do the variations that you can do as modifications, so building you up gradually to get to that point. So first of all, coming back onto your mats, just bring in those legs gently in towards the body. Give yourself a little squeeze, release your spine. And we'll take in the left foot down to the mat. Just taking that right leg, extend it to ceiling. And just either grab around the back of your thigh, your calf muscle. Gently stretch out through that leg. Trying to just push through the heel of your feet so your toes point down. Keep the shoulders relaxed. Nice deep breaths. And then releasing gently, swapping over. Left leg extends to the ceiling. Again, either wrapping those hands around the back of your thigh, your calf muscle. Taking deep breaths, relaxing your shoulders. And again, exhale, just releasing. Pull those legs back into the body. Just give yourself a quick hug. And then we're taking the hands around the backs of the thighs. Just take a couple of rocks just to gently massage through your back. Coming right up through the shoulders. So sit bones. And back to the shoulders. Right up to the sit bones. And then gently coming forwards. All the way onto your hands and your knees. We're just going to gently place your knees right underneath the hips. Take your arms forward gently. And then begin to pull your tummy in and then stretch your chest down to the floor. So you're keeping the arms strong, you're pulling the tummy in, you're just feeling this in your armpits and feeling the chest gently stretch. And then we're just coming all the way back up, bringing the hands a little bit closer in. Taking that right hand, thread it underneath the left arm gently, taking that right shoulder to the mat. And you're just going to take your left hand and place it down to the floor as you stretch and twist to the left, turning the shoulders, trying to get that chest to point up towards the ceiling. You can stay here. If you wanted to go deeper, left hand can maybe reach to that lower back or even just brush your fingers to that right thigh. Just keeping the hips level. And if you wanted to add your left leg here, just keep those hips nice and level and you're tucking the toes under. And then releasing gently. Place that left hand down, pressing right back up. And then taking the left hand and thread it through underneath the right. Taking the left shoulder to the mat. Again, pushing down through that right hand and stretching and twisting to the right. Now keeping those hips level, take the right hand and maybe just take it to the lower back or brush the fingers to that left thigh. And again, you can add your right leg here, tucking the toes under, keep that leg strong. And then releasing the knee down. And then gently taking that hand back to the floor. Again, bringing those hands forwards, just in front of the shoulders. Spread the fingers wide, about shoulder width distance, tuck those toes under. And then gently unfurling your legs, coming right up, downward facing dog. Stretch your body. Bend the knees a little if you need to. Just really getting a good stretch here, noticing how your body feels. And And then walking those hands all the way back to your feet. Just bending those knees gently, holding onto opposite elbow. Let yourself hang here for a few moments into ragdoll. So soften your knees, let your shoulders relax, your head soften. And then relaxing the hands to your hip bones and just gaze forwards. And then slowly you're lifting with a straight back, come all the way up to standing position. Now taking those arms, reach them up to the ceiling, interlacing your fingers and then pushing the palms of the hands away from you. Gently stretch the arms up and keep your shoulders down, tuck the tailbone under, squeeze your legs. Exhale, release the hands back, interlacing the fingers. And then squeezing those arms gently towards each other, trying to get your chest to open. Inhale, lift the chest. Exhale, bend the knees and reach forwards. Take those arms over where you can. Just breathe, softening your knees. Lovely, releasing gently. Lift the head nice and slow, coming all the way back up to standing. Reaching the arms back to ceiling. Interlacing the fingers the other way. So the other index finger on top and push the palms away, drop the shoulders, lift your tummy, squeeze your legs. And then releasing those hands again, gently interlace the fingers behind you, taking the other index finger on top so it'll feel weird. Lift the chest, inhale. Exhale, bend the knees, reach the arms over, stretch the shoulders where you can. This is not about how far those arms are going over. You just want to feel the stretch gently between the shoulder blades and then stretching the collarbones and your chest, your sternum. Just keep breathing. Exhaling out any tension and then releasing gently through those arms. And then just release the backs of the hands to the floor. And then releasing, just walking those hands back out into your downward facing dog. Inhaling forwards and come back into a plank position. So just establishing a nice strong plank here. Hands right underneath your shoulders, pull the chest forwards. Draw your navel in and lengthen your tailbone to your heels. And then coming down to the knees and come all the way to the floor. Gently just roll the shoulders back. Take an in-breath. Exhale, press through the floor, just lift your chest forward slightly, squeeze the elbows in. Just breathing, lengthening through the neck. And then gently softening down. Take another deep in breath. Exhale, rising. Lift a bit higher maybe, keep the shoulders down. Now really engaging through your legs, squeeze your thighs. As you let your chest come down, your legs will lift. And then just keep drawing the shoulders back, maybe lifting the hands off your mat. And then soften down gently, pushing yourself back, toes tuck under, reach back, lengthen the spine, downward facing dog. As you exhale, gaze forwards, just stepping the feet up towards the hands. Inhale, lengthen and stretch out your spine. And again, your hands can come to the shins. Exhale, the head all the way down and bend the knees as deep as you need to. Inhale, roof down to the feet, reach the arms up, stretch at the ceiling. Exhale, those hands to the heart center. So again, just grounding down through your feet. Strong legs, just tucking that tailbone down, draw your navel in, shoulders relaxing. And then take a deep in breath, reach the arms back at the ceiling, lengthen. Exhale, folding forwards, push the hips back, take the hands to the mat. Inhaling, lengthen, stretch your spine. Exhale, just step yourself back. Right back into plank position. Squeeze in those arms. Nice, come down to the mat. One long line if possible. Roll shoulders back, gently lifting back into that baby cobra. Stretch the shoulders back, squeeze through the legs, pull the pulley in. And then just lower your chest as your legs will lift, gently. Reach the arms back. Keep breathing, keep squeezing your tummy in. And then soften those legs gently. Bring the hands down, pushing back. Take that downward dog. And stretch out your spine. And just coming back into those smooth, deep ujjayi breaths. As you exhale, gazing forwards again, stepping the feet up to the hands. Inhaling, lengthen, stretch your spine. Exhale, the head all the way down. Inhale, root down. Reach the arms up, lengthen up towards the ceiling. Exhale, those hands to the heart. Inhale, reaching up. Exhale, folding forwards. Inhaling, lengthen. Exhale, stepping back. Coming into plank. Again, you can come down to the floor. Otherwise, this time you're coming halfway down, Chaturanga Dandasana. Inhale, rising into upward dog, or just taking baby cobra. Exhale, stretching yourself back. Downward dog. Exhaling, gazing forward, stepping, or maybe float the feet to hands. Inhale, lengthen, stretch your spine. Exhale, head down. Inhale, root down, reach these arms up. Stretch up to ceiling. Exhale, those hands to heart. And again, inhale, take those arms up. Exhale, folding forwards. Inhaling, lengthen. Exhale, step back or floating, Chaturanga, or you're coming all the way to the floor. Inhale, rising, upward dog, or just take baby cobra. Exhale, stretching back, downward dog. Now just taking that right leg, lift it up towards the ceiling, bend your knee and just open up those hips. Now then gaze forwards, bring the foot all the way through and just step it to your hands. So here, planting the foot down, so knees right over ankle, pull the leg forwards if you need to. Plant the left heel down and come all the way up, opening into warrior two. So just drop your shoulders, try and draw that right knee back, roll the left thigh back. Stretch the pelvis. Keep breathing. Lovely, and then just straightening out that front leg. Just take a deep in breath here. Exhale, reach and stretch over to the right, pushing through that front hip. Just take your hand down where you can to that right leg and left arm reaching up to ceiling. Just opening into Trikonasana. Just nice deep breaths. Try to lengthen your tailbone. Pull the tummy in, left hip drawing back. Lovely, inhaling, come all the way back up. Exhale, rebending that front leg, taking the hands down to the mat. Very gently dropping the back knee to the floor. Take the arms up, reach up to the ceiling, inhaling. Exhale, gently pushing forward, stretching through the front of that left hip. Taking that hands down behind you, interlacing those fingers, and squeeze those arms gently towards the floor. Just lifting the chest and opening the sternum. Let's keep breathing. Lengthening your tailbone, trying to get the right hip back, left hip forwards. And then releasing, hands gently to the mat. Tuck the toes under, stretch yourself straight back into your downward dog. Left leg lifting up to the ceiling, bending the knee, opening up the hips, stretch the pelvis. And then bringing that foot all the way through, and just up into your hands. Bringing it right down, knee right over your ankle, drop the back heel down, and then come right back up, opening up, warrior two. And again, you're trying to draw that left knee back, right thigh back, drop the shoulders, reach to the arms. And then just inhaling, stretching through that front leg. Lifting up as you exhale, reach and stretch over to the left, coming all the way down. And again, keeping the length in the torso, reaching that right arm up. Keeping everything nice and strong. You want to imagine you're pulling yourself back to an imaginary wall. And then just checking in with your leg. Make sure the knee always is in line with your second big toe. Never allow your knee just to collapse inwards. And breathing. And then inhale, come right back up. Exhale, re-bend that leg. Take the hands down to the floor. And as you again, you're going to drop your back knee down to the mat. Take the hands to that front leg. We'll reach the arms up to ceiling. Inhale. Exhale, pressing forward, stretching to the front of that right hip. And then taking the hands back, interlacing the fingers, trying to get the other index finger on top, and drop the shoulders back. Just pull those hands gently to the floor. And then releasing, take those hands down gently. Tuck the toes under on that back leg and then just push back straight into your downward facing dog. And then easing forwards. Again, you're stepping or floating the feet up to hands. Inhaling, stretching through your spine. Exhaling the head all the way down. Inhale now, bend the knees, coming into a deep Utkatasana. Reaching those arms up, pull the belly in. Try and lengthen your tailbone. Keep the shoulders down. And then come all the way down, take the hands to the mat. Take an in-breath as you lengthen out through your spine, stretching the back. Exhale, step the left foot back behind you. Take a deep lunge. Reach the arms up, stretch the ceiling to a high lunge. Drop the shoulders down. And then release, hands to the floor. Bring the left foot right back up to meet the right. Inhale, stretch the back. Exhale, the head down. Inhale, bend those knees, come back into Utkatasana. As you exhale, come forwards, take the hands to the mat. Inhaling, lengthen. Exhale, right foot stepping back behind you, nice deep lunge. Reaching the arms up to ceiling to high lunge. Just keeping the shoulders down, pull the tummy in. And then releasing hands to the mat. Bring the right foot back up to meet your left foot. Inhale, lengthen, stretch the back. Exhale the head down. Inhale, length and stretch your back once again. Exhale, left foot stepping back, drop the heel to the mat. Inhale, reaching the arms at the ceiling, into warrior one. Trying to get that right hip back, the left hip forwards, dropping that right hip down, squeezing and bending that front leg. Reach up through the arms. Take the arms as wide as you need them. Get those arms straight. Keep breathing. As you exhale, let the hands come down. Bring that left foot back up to meet the right. Inhale. Exhale, right foot stepping back. Drop the heel down. Inhale, bend the legs, stretching those arms up. Back into warrior one. So again, get that left hip pulling back and dropping it down. Squeeze to that back leg, bend the front leg, drop the shoulders, keep reaching up through those arms. So if you can, you're gazing up. And releasing hands down, stepping back, downward facing dog. So just gently stretching back and then inhaling and coming forwards, right up into a plank position. And then from your plank, you're just going to come all the way down to the mat. You can take the knees down first, release the shoulders. Again, just take a deep in-breath, and as you exhale, push to the floor, lifting up. Just take into a little cobra or higher cobra if you can, and squeeze your legs, re-engaging your thighs. As you lower your chest, your legs will lift. And take those arms back, stretching out through your chest. Keep pulling the tummy in and trying to spiral the inner thighs up. And then gently releasing. Take those forearms right underneath you, elbows underneath shoulders. Bring the hands together, tuck those toes under, and then lifting the hips, squeezing your tummy in. So coming into dolphin plank. Just keep trying to lengthen, try and keep a nice long line down the whole body. And then walk the feet in, very gently, coming into dolphin. So lifting high, push down through your arms, really getting a good stretch into your shoulders. Try and pull your tummy in, pull your ribs in. So the idea is to get the shoulders stretching, pull the chest towards the front of your thighs. Your head should be off the floor. But don't worry if your shoulders are really tight, you can't quite get the head off the mat just yet. Just keep practicing. You will get there eventually. And then just walk the feet back. Back into dolphin. Squeeze the legs. Lovely. And then from here, you're going to roll over to that right elbow. Taking the right foot to the floor, so right on the outer edge. Now you can bring this left foot in front of you if you find that you're really quite weak in those legs and you really struggle. Really strengthen, take the left arm up to ceiling. Now if you're going well, both feet come together and squeeze down, push through that right arm, through the right foot, into that side plank. Holding here, squeezing your tummy in. You can gaze down if you find that your balance is not great. And then releasing. Come back into your dolphin plank. Again, holding. And then we'll come right over to the left side. So outer edge of the left foot to the mat. Again, coming down with the right foot in front of you if you need to. If you need that extra support. Otherwise, both feet together. So you're working your core quite strongly, really engaging into your side obliques, the transverse abdominis. Keep breathing. And this really helps with inversions, really engaging your core and strengthening. So coming back into that dolphin plank, holding, squeezing those legs. Drop the knees if you need to. And then come down to the knees. Just walk your hands back. Take a child's pose. Stretch your spine. And then slowly come right back up. Coming forwards. Just coming down to sit. Or coming into another pose for your core. So again, you can take a block, lace it between your knees, squeeze the block. This will help to work your inner thighs, but also helps to re-engage into the lower abdominals or your pelvic floor. So again, the hands right underneath, lift your chest up, walk the toes back, find your balancing point by just lifting those toes off your mat. You can hold here. Maybe you're going a bit deeper and bring the legs up. And maybe if you're going really well, the arms reach forwards. Just keep holding, keep breathing. Relax the shoulders down. So keep squeezing that block. And don't worry if your legs start to shake, but just keep in check with your breaths. Keep your breaths nice and smooth. And if they start to shake, then maybe you're just pushing yourself a bit too deeply. So just come out of the pose and rest. And then soften down gently. Release the block, cross the shins. Take the hands to the floor, either stay up high or if you can, walk the hands forwards. We're just stretching those muscles through those back of the hips. So working through the back of those hips and the pelvis, stretching out, ready for doing halasana. Keep the back of your neck long if you're quite deep into this pose. Just breathing and relaxing through it. And coming gently out, crossing the shins the other way. Again, bring the hands down. You may be staying up a bit higher, or you're coming forwards. So you'll notice that this is working the opposite hip now. So it's important that you do both legs to balance out your pelvis, keeping it nice and balanced. Just keep breathing. And then coming right back up. Coming back to lie on your mats. Bring the legs in. Give yourself a gentle hug. And then bring the feet to the mat. Have the feet hip width distance, tuck the tailbone under, try and flatten that low back down. Squeeze into the abdominals and try and get your hips to squeeze in towards the lower ribs. Push down through the floor, lifting up into bridge. So keeping that work of trying to get those top of the hip bones to pull in as tight towards the lower ribs. And this is helping just to lengthen out through that lower back. Keep your hands down. If you can, walk them in. Just get those hands, just clasp and roll the shoulders up high. Getting the neck to gently stretch, the shoulders to stretch. Keep pushing through the feet. Just check in those knees aren't falling out to the sides. Keep squeezing them in. And any of these poses we're doing now, you're making sure you're looking directly up to the ceiling. So if you wanted to do them, just watch the video first and then have a go after. And then you kind of know what you're doing. Just try not to turn your head in these poses. So just slowly come all the way down, vertebrae by vertebrae, to the mat. Take a break, just take the feet together, let the knees drop out. Just take a few breaths. And then bring those knees towards each other. So again, you're going to use your block here. So take in that block, lift up your sit bones and take the block, place it right under the sit bones, the lower back, next to the tailbone. And then just holding the block, take the knees in. And all you're going to do is just gently extend those legs up so you can keep your knees bent or you straighten the legs out completely. Just lifting up nice and tall with those legs stretching out. You can stay here for as long as you wish to. You can hold this pose and you don't have to go any further. If you wish to go deeper, then maybe you're just taking the feet down, taking that block and just taking it a bit higher up your back. And this time you're bringing the hands down and then slowly bringing the knees in. And then you're trying to get the knees into your chest. So again, you can just hold it here. You don't have to go any further. Just holding the feet up. And then maybe you're stretching those legs out completely. Now you're going to know whether you're feeling this already. You'll feel this in those ligaments on the lower back if you're tight here, or you're feeling it in those hamstrings. Whatever you're feeling, maybe this is where you need to stop. If you wanted to go deeper, push the hands into the floor and take those legs over. And again, your feet may not completely come down to the mat behind you. So you can just keep those hands on the lower back, maybe even bend the knees and rest them to the forehead. You do what you need to do. And if you have got those toes touching down on the mat, you may be interlacing those fingers. I've just moved the block out of the way. Interlacing the fingers and walk the arms in a little, right up under the shoulders. And your inhalasana, plow pose. So squeeze your belly in, engage your core. Try and lift up through the sit bones. Lengthen your chin away from your chest and breathe. Now, if you're quite tight in your legs, an alternative is taking a few blocks, have them prepared to be underneath your feet. So you do this if you're right up in sitting pose, measure where the blocks are going to be, and then when you take the legs over, you've got some support. You can even use a chair for this. So if you've got a stool or a chair you can place your feet on, so it just helps you if you don't quite touch the mat. And then if you're going well here, you may be bringing those hands to your back. Keep your hands flat, the fingers pointing out. And then just let the weight of your bottom come down to those hands, arching your spine slightly. As you do this, your legs are just going to gently rise. Now you can't have your knees bent. Just keeping those legs strong, belly pulled in. If you're going well, straightening the legs. Just lifting them slightly higher, kind of a 45 degree angle. So this is a supported shoulder stand. So this is just an alternative if you can't quite get into full shoulder stand. And again, be aware of your neck. Make sure you're not overstretching. And then, so from your supported shoulder stand, you can take another pose here. Just gently lift up the hips slightly. And then just taking that right leg, you're stretching it out down away from you. And then from here, keep this left leg where it is. You're just going to bend the right leg and bring this right leg all the way through and straighten it out. Again, exhale, take it out. And then inhale, bend the knee as if you're just bicycling your leg. Inhale, stretching. Exhale it out. Inhale it back. Exhale. Inhale it back for four. Exhale. Inhaling in for five. Exhale. Inhaling in for six. Trying to stretch out as much as you can that extension through the leg. Pull the belly in. And for seven. Stretching out. For eight. Stretch it out. For nine. And coming finally to 10, stretching out, bending the knee, bring it back in, stretch it out to the other side. Left leg stretching out now, and then bending the knee, bicycle it in, extend and stretch them both together. Exhale, leg comes out, bend the knee, bring it back in for two. Exhale, and inhaling for three. Exhale. Inhaling for four, exhale, five, exhale, six, keep pulling the belly in, exhale, for seven, exhale, for eight, and exhale, for nine, just one more, exhale, for 10, bringing the leg back in, holding here. So either at this stage just come out of the pose, or we're preparing to do full shoulder stand. So if you need to take a break, just pause the video. If you've never done a shoulder stand before, then just stay here. Just practice Halasana, and this pose here. Now, if you are stronger in your neck, you're feeling okay, you've got good flexibility, just take the feet back to the mat once again. Interlace your fingers, try and get those arms to roll back in. Take the hands back to that lower back, and then slowly take one leg up. You can just hold here, stretching that one leg up, pulling the tummy in. Maybe have a few breaths there, and swap legs. Just getting yourself prepared. Again, you've really got to use your core strength to lift up in this pose. And then if you're going well, other leg joins, and reaching up. The more you can walk your hands towards the top of your spine, towards the shoulder blades, the higher you'll get. But just bearing in mind your neck, and try not to overforce anything. Just keep breathing. And you can gently come down back into Halasana. Hold the pose as long as you wish to. If you wanted to stay a little bit longer, you could. And just come out of the pose as you came in. So again, taking the arms down. And again, press the palms to the floor and slowly, slowly, with control, come out of the pose, vertebrae over vertebrae, all the way to the mat. And as the bottom comes down, you just lift your head slightly and plant the head back. Bend the knees. Give yourself a hug. If you wanted to, you could keep your legs straight. Maybe take the hands right underneath those sit bones and take the legs down nice and slow with control, using your core. Keep breathing. Squeeze those abdominals in, lower back flat to the mat. Taking it down slowly, slowly, slowly. Coming to the floor. If you haven't already, get your hands right underneath those sit bones. Push down through your elbows and forearms and gently lift the chest up. Let your head gently rest back. Just taking a few breaths here. And then bringing the chin back in, nice and slow, back to the floor, bring those knees in, give yourself a hug. So just stay here for a few moments. For alternative to fish pose, which is the pose you've just done, I've had a few clients who have problems with their elbows. So you can take your hands down to the mat behind you in a seated pose, and then gently let your head rest back. And open up the chest that way. Either way, just keeping the chest lifting. Turn the hands the other way if you have wrist issues. And again, gently let the head come back. And just take it where you can here. And then gently bring the chin in. I prefer doing the original pose, but if you have those issues, then they can sometimes help. So again, you can get those legs in. Taking a happy baby, grab the feet and taking them wide, open up, draw the knees down, flatten the spine to the floor, nice to stretch your back. And then releasing, and again you can take a twist here. So you're just keeping the knees together. If you wish to, you can cross your right leg over your left leg. Shift your hips a little bit to the right, and your knees are going to come all the way to the left. Get that right shoulder back to the mat and really extend and lengthen the arm out. You can turn your head, but keep your chin in. And just taking a few breaths. You should feel nice on that back and your neck. And then bring the head gently centre, and those legs to centre, and then crossing those legs. Taking the other side now, so shift the hips a little bit over to the left. Cross the left leg over your right. Knees are coming down to the right hand side. And again, really trying to get the left shoulder to gently draw back toward the floor. Turning the head, keeping the chin in. And just feeling that gentle stretch. Of course, this is two, which just move the knees a bit further down the mat. You don't have to take it as deep. And then head to center, legs back to center, and cross those legs gently. So just lift up the tailbone, lengthen it out, down and release. Let the legs relax down, the arms soften out to the sides, the palms gently up. So you can just gently press the thumbs and the first fingers into the mat, exaggerating that movement of the arms rolling back, and then relax them. Just feeling a deep sense of release as you give in. Closing your eyes, taking a few moments now just to relax in Shavasana. Just bringing the breath to a natural rhythm. And of course, you can stay here for as long as you would like to. Otherwise, if you're happy to, just move through the fingers once again. Coming back with the body, reawakening. Stretching the arms up gently. Bringing the knees in, giving yourself a hug. Just taking your time and rolling over to that right side to the recovery position. And pressing yourself right back up to seated. And taking the hands lightly to the heart center. Roll the shoulders down. Take a few moments to send the body love and light. Having a wonderful sense of gratitude for all the hard work your body has just done. And just remembering that the thoughts that you have affect how your body reacts. Sending your body love and light and positivity helps your body to heal and rejuvenate. And then sending this wonderful energy out, this newfound energy you have in your body, to all beings everywhere. Namaste. Have a wonderful day. Thank you.